Hi everyone, Koplan hier again. It's been a long time. The latest expansion just hit and I did not buy anything yet. Just stocked up on or saved up on my coins. And in this video, I will just dump them into those 100 gold crates chest. As usually with every expansion, I personally always wait until the full expansion crate chests are available for 100 gold. I do not buy any 200 gold crates simply because that's half as many gems or legendary cards as with the 100 gold chests. And the RNG is anyway will anyway prevent you from getting reliable getting those cards that you want, especially the legendaries. So this is the best bang for your buck, and yeah, so let's get started. Any cards that I already had was solely from the normal crate rewards or from events. And I think I even got one of the mission cards from my normal crate. There's the new Warlord. Deal 2 damage to a sentenced enemy or give it sentenced one this turn. Very good in conjunction with mission card from the Raven Guard. Also, I personally don't like either the sentence mechanic as well as stealth in general. This one is also good with that new Warlord. Was already in a match on the opposing side of him, and it's really annoying. This card is also interesting, along with the new cards. The first time you could give sentence to all enemies on the field. Crates, no legendary yet. As a new Raven Guard sorry, Salamander Warlord. I personally, yeah, they changed them already. He's a little bit better. It used to be draw a card for two, and if it is a teaching, then you gain plus one in frontline. Now it's of course a lot better, but I still this initiative low. I don't know. By the way, according to Discord, this card seems currently bugged. A player reported that he played it in the event, and I think he said the gem was applied, but not the 5 damage. So, according to him, that's why he lost the match. One of the new practicals. It's also one you can generate with Reboot. It's pretty good to get your apothecary back on the field, for instance, to annoy the enemy much more. So, 25 crates. Five more for a guaranteed legendary. Of course, I don't have the luck to get one earlier. Oh, Sons of the Forge. So the new Salamander mission. Okay. I really like to read it now and not be blinded. Okay. And yeah, we are back to zero. The good thing with this expansion is, as there are no, as far as I know, no new Primarchs, of course, or any other legendary warlords. Every legendary card should appear in the shop sooner or later. So if you don't manage to complete your collection of legendaries just by buying the crates, then it shouldn't take too long to finish the expansion due to the job. So these guys are also one of the reason one should put much more stealth hate into your decks right now, not only because of the Raven Guard. Because before I think stealth was very rarely an issue. I kept the informant networks mostly for the defenders of Caliban to get rid of that Jägers and stuff. But now I think they are more mandatory, and maybe even Joker Company, Moses Guitaris should be put back inside. Quits. By the way, if anyone wonders, because there's always, especially on Steam, some discussion about the monetization model of the game and that you can't craft the cards and that's too expensive and so on. But the 16,000 gold I had were simply collected between now and the last expansion. So full crates, the Terra crates. And I didn't buy anything and it just came by doing the daily missions, the daily 5 wins. The challenge crates and the occasional event, and even on the events I was pretty lazy due to not having too much time, usually only doing one 10 ticket run, which is another reason why I have 433 tickets stocked up. Okay, here is another, I think it was crate 25 or something like that. I actually thought I had that one tactic, but I remember now it was Iron Hands or Iron Warrior tactics that I had. But this is pretty cool and pretty easy to pull off, especially with a new Warlord. So, but on average, 16,000 gold, 6,000 down. You need 3,000 for 30 crates. Basically, my luck is like low. I mostly only gets the legendaries from the guaranteed 30th crate. I mean, it's okay, better than nothing, but of course, would be nice to get a lucky pull here and there in between. By the way, I don't think we did need more stunning effects in the game, and this for one energy for a common card. I mean, it's fair enough per se, but on the various Alpha Legion builds, it's just more annoying than it needs to be. Especially as the new mission for the Alpha Legion is to prevent your opponent from attacking. And they already had plenty of stunning, and now it's two more stuns in the card pool for them. Crates. By the way, the warding mechanic is also something that I dislike, especially if the troops carrying it are so strong, like the higher cost Space Wolf units, like that new Dreadnought. The thing is, difference to stealth, stealth is usually being removed when the unit attacks, of course. Ward stays on the unit no matter what it does, and there is no card that has wording like removes ward from anything or so. So there's no counter. The only counter is headbanging into them or having some indirect effects like Window of the Weak, but not everyone has access to that, and yeah, it's too situational. There's really not a good counterplay to it. Should be another legendary soon. Twenty secrets. By the way, I still do hope that at least in the next expansion, we will see some more cards and some reworks, hopefully, for the Custodes faction, because I don't really think they are competitive for quite a while already, unless you can trigger Wildor. It's pretty rough. Of course, you can do some nice gimmick Nassau decks. If he keeps putting down weak units or units that you can kill with Nassau, and you can stay out of reach for them. But the Sentinel trait is still in there. Next mission, thanks. And is still hampering them. I mean, everyone knows how important card draw is, and having a card on the field that prevents you from drawing cards is it's crazy, and I don't think anyone can still argue that the stats of the Custodes are enough to warrant the trade. And also First Strike is not all that anymore. In my book, Sneak Attack is better because it First Strike only works when you can kill the troop with your first attack. Sneak Attack is much better. Hey! Of course, it's one of the crappier missions. Number one is the enemy can easily prevent you from generating 15 energy with troops. And the card you unlock then, Unleashed Minds, is not really the game winner that you'd like it to be then, in the end. And the problem with all those missions is, you start with it in your starting hand, and if you use Magnus in this case, or any Primarch, you're already short on cards anyway. If you play the Lion and use also his quests, then you have only the two quest and mission cards and no other card on hand. So basically you're starting with your arms behind your back. Yeah, 8-8 Frontlight and Ward, cool. Of course 9 is expensive, but it's a vehicle, so you can get it cheaper and draw it from your deck, and of course, because it's warded, yeah, you can't destroy it with tactics. So target vehicles. Oh. The score is improving. By the way, is this tactic? Meh. 4 for single turn plus 2 and draw card. I don't know. Draw card is nice, but don't know. I mean, except for Zangwillas, you wouldn't attack much with your warlords anyways. Blood Angels. And Zangwillas has better ways to boost his attacks. Blade and Carmine. So, we should get at least two more legendaries. This could be interesting to play, but 10 energy, of course, it's 10 energy. You should be able to win the game, and putting a random amount or a random four vehicles in play, which can only act the next turn. I don't know. Cards. So, let's see if we get one another or two. As I said, Khan of Khans is also a weird tactic because the most successful White Scout decks are of course not using many Astartes, instead using their vehicles. But we will see if they, if someone finds a good use for it. I mean, you could get the Headhunters or Headtakers for it, which are pretty good. Especially after they buffed the Helds. So, 24 crates. Ah, 26. And it's one we don't have yet, which is always nice. So, sadly, we don't have enough to get a guaranteed another one, so I will just stop here for now and just take a look at the collection now. And that's exactly what I don't like. I want to see all cards from the expansion Galaxy in Flames. And the filtering here does not work for that, which is sad. So, okay, we don't have the Cacophony Commander, we don't have the Chosen of Slaanesh yet. We don't have Chosen of Khorne, I think, yes. I don't have Chosen of the Four yet. Okay, Gift of Fortitude is still missing. Chosen of Olympia is still missing. And one of Siege Mastery, which is not that important. Here we got it. Burnt of Hito is coming, uncommon, and we don't have it yet. Or where? It's called where here, yeah. Lords of the Night still missing. And only one Captain Arnunik. This looks pretty good. Ah, Zelos Pawn is missing. Sons of Medusa is missing. Bitter Memories is missing. Which is pretty good. Sons of the Forge we have. I think this looks good. Sons of Ultramar is missing. Sons of Baal is missing. We have the Order of the Yagatai. Zolmon is missing. We don't have the Science of the First yet. We don't have the Sons of Dawn yet. And sadly we don't have her yet. But everything else. Ah, Forge Master is also missing. Don't have the Auspex. Of course, we don't have Zorg yet. And no Remnant. Yeah, but it's okay, I think. It's the most we have now. I'd really like a compact list by expansion. Okay, but as I said, for instance, Tybalt Maro, I think we did draw him. I didn't buy him yet. Yeah, and we will probably be able to buy the other missions sooner or later in the shop, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, so that's enough for now. Dropped most of my coins now. Yeah. So I think it was pretty okay for the gold invested. Alright, that was Koblan unboxing the new expansion. Wish you good luck with your chests and your draws and in the current event. Have a good one and have fun with the new cards. Bye!